ban on breeding lionfish, an invasive species that's taking over our coral reefs.
Tonight, CBS4's Brian Andrews reports on new research underway that may have found the key to beating the lionfish problem.
Okay, here we have a lionfish.
There is no real way to ice this invasive fish just yet.
This is overtaking the reefs, and I heard it eats a lot of the species down here, too.
It eats everything.
But Fish in North Miami says putting lionfish on the menu is one way to help rid our reefs of this nuisance.
This thing eats baby tropical fish like crazy.
Check out this one in the tank.
A little bit, a little more.
We will put the fries right here, and I think we got it.
We know how this one ended up, but how did the fish native to the Indian Ocean end up in our ocean?
It happened down here, though. That's the one thing we know. Florida was the epicenter.
Somebody set their pet lionfishes free at the beach in the late 80s, and ever since...
They curled around and have since invaded pretty much the entire Caribbean and the Gulf of Mexico.
That's because scientists say lionfish are champion fornicators.
There are reports of them spawning about every 4 days. Under the right conditions, which means that there are a lot of potential baby lionfish out there.
Since they were introduced into our waters without any natural enemies,
our fish probably don't know how to eat them, don't know how to approach the poisonous spines, don't even know to recognize them as potential food items. It's sort of a perfect storm for an invasive species.
So NSU researchers decided to look for a scientific way to nip the lionfish problem that started with an email to researchers from South America to Bermuda.
Send us all the fish you can catch. And they did that by the box load.
Grant money helped pay for shipping.
So here's an example of a bag of lionfish that came in from one of our collaborators in the Caribbean.
If the fish are fresh, we try to dissect them right away before they get really stinky.
Researchers are looking for parasites.
The critters that are living within these lionfish.
No, it's not sushi, it's science.
Answers hidden in the anatomy.
Do these fish have any parasites? Did they bring any new parasites with them that might affect local fish? And have they picked up any of the local parasites? And what role could those local parasites play in ultimately controlling the lionfish?
And the aha moment from the research?
Some of the native parasites are getting themselves into the lionfish, and so it may act as a natural break to the population.
This is the lionfish sashimi, or the start of it, yeah.
For now, if you can't beat them, eat them.
I should try one.
Yes.
That's when it's done. He's not swimming no more.
In North Miami, Brian Andrews, CBS 4 News.
Looks safe.